jumping in the water, it's like a shock. Feeling the cold water, feeling your body like go through the water when you initially dive in is a unique feeling. You submerge under the water and then you only hear the water. Like you don't hear anything else anymore. It's just like this almost like peace. The sport is very repetitive. It's a lot of time in your head, in your own lane, with your head in the water, doing the same repetitive movements over and over again. It is the perfect opportunity to be present and to teach yourself presence. Being the middle child was super fun because I had an older sibling and I also had a younger sibling. I have an older brother, younger sister. We're all 18 months apart. So I think back now and wonder how my mom did it, because it must have been crazy with all three of us so young and so close in age. I had a backyard pool growing up, so we were always out there. I just remember like summer days spending hours and hours in the pool, and even like into the evenings. And then once it got dark, it was like, okay, we have to get out of the pool, but it's like our parents had to drag us out of the water. I think that's also when my parents realized, like, I just love being in the water. My parents were super supportive of just having an active lifestyle. So I also played soccer for a number of years competitively, and I played house league hockey. So I was already doing two sports, but it got to a point where I was doing all three, and then I realized that there wasn't enough hours in the day to be able to do everything. And I kind of had to decide, like, okay, what do I want to do? I think at that age, when I was 12, 13, 14, around that age, it's pretty late, I would say, to kind of specifically choose swimming as my sport. But even then, when I was making that decision, I wasn't thinking down the line. I just genuinely enjoyed swimming with the people that I was swimming with, and it kept me wanting to come to practice. I think that balanced approach of not having such a focus and specific goals at such a young age, for me at least, I think that helped me in the long run, because it just allowed me to enjoy the sport for what it was and like be able to kind of slowly build my goals and build my strengths within the sport. I think as you get older, you really appreciate what your parents did for you growing up even more. So looking back, I'm super thankful to have had such a supportive family who allowed me to find my passion in the sport. I mean, I think everyone faces adversity in many different ways, and I think anything can be considered adversity. It's all about perspective and how you choose to adapt or manage that adversity. As I got older, probably like grade 10, 11, 12, there was a period of time where I definitely struggled a bit, because I saw a lot of my friends in my club team and just friends in the sport succeeding, and I kind of was like a bit behind them, I would say. And I think that was to do with the fact that I was a little bit of a late bloomer and just hadn't really like grown into my body yet, and was still kind of developing the foundation for the technique and for the strokes and everything in the sport. And that part was hard for me. I remember questioning it for sure, like, is this something I want to continue to do? Is this for me? At a young age like that, it's hard to see for sure, especially when you're going to swim meets weekend after weekend. Seeing everyone else do way better than you is tough at a young age, but I'm thankful for those challenges, because I think they instilled great values in me now, because I know that I had to put in the work and I had to work hard to get to where I am now. More recently, I guess, I used to swim at the University of Toronto under Byron and Linda, and I had been with them since I went to university. So that was, I think, 6 or 7 years. And then when COVID hit, the only place to train was coming to the High Performance Center of Ontario. Obviously, that was super exciting because it was such an amazing group, amazing coaches, amazing staff working there, and I was super excited to join them. But at the same time, I was leaving something that had been my home for the last 7 years, and it was all I knew. So that's not necessarily what you want to be doing right before the Olympic Games, is completely change your program, training, pretty much lifestyle, because it was a completely different swap for me. As much as I had high goals still for Tokyo, my goals didn't change amongst the craziness. In 2016, and that being my first like senior international team, I just remember it was so cool for me to be going to the Olympic Games. I was so excited to be there and to just be with my role models, to be teammates with them, and to be able to be swimming next to them was so exciting for me. Obviously, I was nervous and I wanted to do well, but I didn't put any pressure on myself, and I was really just trying to soak up the whole experience and enjoy what I was doing and to just swim.
And it is McEwen who sneaked ahead. It's McEwen for gold. It's Kylie Moss for her second silver medal.
But in Tokyo, I was definitely disappointed. I wanted to be able to have an Olympic gold, and I wanted to be on the top of that podium. I knew it was going to be a challenge, and I knew it was going to be a battle, but I work every day to be the best athlete that I can be and to be able to fight for being the best in the world. Coming away with a silver was still a little bit disappointing for me, and I definitely struggle with vocalizing that immediately after, like post-Olympics within interviews, because I just didn't really know how to fully express how I felt. Maybe I didn't want to completely, so I kind of just shied away from saying anything.
Yeah, I'm really happy. I think it's the second fastest time I've been, so I can't really complain.
I think it's completely normal to be able to experience both emotions, and I think that's a good balance. Like, I think that's something that I want to continue to be able to experience, is both sides of it, because it's good to be able to recognize the accomplishment and to be able to praise yourself for achieving that. But if you're hungry for more, or if you're disappointed in how you executed something, like, it's good to be able to also reflect on what you want to improve on. I hope to continue to push myself within the sport. I think it's really exciting to look back on my performances, even in Tokyo, and know that there's areas in my races where I want to improve and I want to be faster. So I hope to do that. I hope as I got older within the team, I mean, I hope I became a leader and became someone that people could look up to and rely on and look to if they needed anything. I think that's something my parents definitely instilled in me, making sure just like everyone is included and everyone feels comfortable, and being there if someone has any concerns or questions. Yeah, be there for my teammates, because that's so powerful to just be able to observe someone who's been in the sport for a while and knows what they're doing, and being able to have people in that situation, because the environment is so intense and everyone's trying to reach their goals in that moment. I think having that mutual respect for one another and the power of like succeeding as a whole is so cool.